10 years ago today, Egyptian strongman Hosni Mubarak was removed from power in what was seen as a tremendous success of the so-called Arab Spring, a movement that spread across the Middle East and other parts of the world, civilian protests forcing change. But a decade on, civil war, new protests and humanitarian crises. Well, CNN's Ben Wedeman was in the thick of things back in 2011, covering the unrest. He's been taking a look back at that time, and I do want to warn you, some of what you are about to see is graphic.
It began in Tunisia. The people toppled the aging dictator Zain El Abidine Ben Ali.
I'm afraid that the other regimes, yes, of the Arabic countries, they will. They are afraid that this revolution will succeed.
The revolt spread to Egypt. To Libya.
This demonstration in Benghazi gives you an idea of the passion of the people of this city, of the passion of so many Libyans.
People rose up in Bahrain, in Syria, and in Yemen. Egypt's Hosni Mubarak resigned after 29 years in power, and the army moved in, applauded as saviors. But the illusion that the people and the army are one didn't last. The men in uniform soon reverted to their old ways, the boot and the club. After a year of rule by Egypt's first ever democratically elected government, led by the Muslim Brotherhood, the military rode a wave of discontent and seized power, killing almost 1,000 of the ousted government's supporters and imprisoning tens of thousands more. General, now President, Abdel Fattah al-Sisi has crushed even the mildest forms of dissent, spending hundreds of billions of dollars on mega projects reminiscent of his pharaonic predecessors. In Bahrain, the autocrats of the Gulf, led by Saudi Arabia, joined to crush the uprising. Yemen is now a civil war and a regional war all in one. Among the worst humanitarian disasters of the 21st century so far. While in Libya, the rebels killed Muammar Gaddafi, but the uprising split the country between still warring rival governments. In Syria, the revolt morphed into a sectarian bloodbath, a macabre theater of regional and international rivalries, killing more than 400,000 people, driving millions into exile, opening the door to extremists like ISIS and others. In the end, the foreign powers that cheered on the uprisings turned away, going back to the old formula of better the devil you know. The so-called Arab Spring, like Pandora's box, released pain, suffering, and sorrow. But the hope it also released lives on. The memory of those heady days hasn't vanished, says Amnesty International's Hebba Morayef.
There are entire generations who saw these Arab autocrats fall in 2011, one after the other. And that's an incredibly powerful idea in terms of what can be achieved through people power.
The struggle for dignity and freedom in the Arab world is long and bloody, but it may eventually bend toward justice.
And Ben joining us now from Beirut, where he is based these days. You strike a somewhat optimistic note in that report at the end about a period, the report about a period that many say ultimately achieved very little. Ben, your response?
I think we have to take a somewhat longer view at what has happened over the last 10 years. The last 10 years have been horrific in terms of the loss of life, destruction, sort of you name it. But I think there's a growing awareness that The dictatorships that today we treat as permanent are not. That the younger generation is becoming more and more technologically savvy. For every technology that's developed to repress, there are technologies developed to get around those means of oppression. And you cannot live in a vacuum in terms of politics. People know what's going on in the world. And so dictatorships rise, dictatorships fall, and that is going to happen eventually in the Middle East. Injustice is not permanent. And therefore, as people learn how to organize, for instance, in 2011, the young people who came into Tahrir Square were almost shocked by how easy, only about 800 people were killed in that uprising, was to bring down Mubarak. I think now people in Sudan and Lebanon and even in Egypt are learning that if you organize properly and you think ahead, perhaps you can bring down these dictatorships. But I think no one is under the illusion that it's going to be easy. Becky?
An important date to mark. Ben, thank you.